Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and welcome to the inaugural episode of Baking with BIS. Woo, wow. So, as you may be able to tell, my computer is still not here. I have, like, my little laptop, but that's about it. So we had to come up with something to do, and what we're going to do is bake. Now, the camera's a little bit wobbly. I'm doing this one-handed. I'm going to tell a quick little story. I did actually record this. I recorded the first 20 minutes or so of the baking just before the dough went in the fridge. And I did it, rather genius tactic, I'm sure you'll appreciate, but I strapped my mobile phone to my forehead via sellotape. And it seemed to work fine, but then I looked back at the video and unfortunately, you couldn't see a bloody thing. Like, everything was just a little bit out of shot. Everything was a teeny, teeny bit out of shot. So instead, we're gonna do this one-handed. It's gonna be a little bit higgledy-piggledy and hard to do, but life finds a way, as they say, folks. Life finds a way. So what are we baking? Very exciting. We are baking... Da-da-da-da. I did that a little bit late. we're going to make gingerbread biscuits, specifically. Or cookies, if you're American, I suppose. I can still say cookie here, to be fair. Gingerbread biscuits. But what you do is you get them like this. So when they're still soft, just before you put them in the oven. So you chill them, you take them out. We're going to cut them using stencils. And then you get these little indent kind of things. Let me see if I can... Yeah, like this, right? And the indent puts like a little holes in the biscuit, which you then flood later on with icing. And they look like skeletons. And I thought that was really cool. And, you know, dinosaur themed. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to make gingerbread dead dinosaurs. Basically, this is the second time I've done this, so... If it doesn't work this time, I don't know what I'm going to do with myself. And I am sat down this time because I can't be bothered walking around again. So, let's get to work. What we're going to do first is load up all our ingredients in the big bowl over here. Now, the first thing we need in the big bowl is bicarbonate of soda. Here it is, looking bicarb. Everyone just like open everything in preparation. So, we need to kick things off. Half a teaspoon. Teaspoon. I should do this in the other hand. Come here. Half a teaspoon of bicarb. So, here we go. This is why people don't bake one-handed, by the by. It's about half, that's fine. Baking, wow. We need a... How much cinnamon do we need? We need a teaspoon of cinnamon. Cinnamon. Now, I don't believe the teaspoon will fit in the cinnamon. Not really. So what we need to do is pour the cinnamon onto the teaspoon. One-handed. This is fine. This is science. This is a-okay. It's fine. Baking. Wow. God damn it. Right. We also need, of course, it is a gingerbread after all. Lots of ginger. I say lots. A tablespoon of the ginger. Let's get it on there. I'll tidy up as I go. This triggers me a little bit, I'll admit. I really like, come here. The ginger could do with bashing up a bit, but it'll be fine. Baking. I'm gonna put a little bit more in. I like my gingerbread to be quite fiery. Maybe I should get some like raw ginger. I don't have any. Get in there, come on. That'll do. I really like to keep like a really clean kitchen. I like to tidy up as I go, but I don't really think I can do that. Anyways, we also need flour. So let's get all this nonsense out of the way. Let's get our scales. There we go. There's a reason people don't bake sat down. It doesn't bloody work. Should say zero. Lovely stuff. And this bit may be impossible to do one-handed. Because I need to sift the flour. What if I... okay, I'm gonna sift it in 225 grams of plain flour, but I don't see a way of showing you that, so bear with me. As if by magic, through the wonders of video editing, maybe I have to do this on my phone, I don't really know how this is gonna work out, honestly. 225 grams of beautifully sifted flour has appeared. So, let's move that off to the side, we don't need that quite ashy. Actually, what we do need to do though, is give it a little shuffle. Try not to... There's buttons on the side of my phone. I accidentally stopped the recording. Okay, you have to get really close in here because I need to hold the bowl. Just going to give that a little mix. Okay, there you go. There's as close to a bowl of flour as you will ever have your face. Look at that little burst of cinnamon there. I can't be having that. Little bursty bits. Not down with the bursties. That'll do. That'll bloody do. Right. Let's tap that off. We're going to need Mr. Bob Spoonage very soon. You can go to the side, my friend. Now, gingerbread, as everyone knows, is the sexiest biscuit. So we do need some hot stuff. So this is our little hot pan here. Well, it's not hot yet. Obviously, that would be stupid. And what we need for Mr. Hot Pan, that's his official name, is 100 grams of butter. My big butter knife is over here. Now, this is not a butter knife. So this is actually a 250 gram block of butter. So you'd say that's about 125, right? Yes, let's go a little bit to the right, probably about there. You have to bear with me for a second. Bloody Nora. Bear with me for a momento. This is like intense baking where you get right up with the blade of the knife. So I'm guessing that's about 100, might be a little bit under. Let's find out. You ready? It's exciting. 104, whew. It's a big boy. Okay. What we also need in this melted mixture is some sugar. For some reason I left over there. It should be 100 grams of dark muscovado. I don't really have dark muscovado, but I've got demerara and it's basically the same thing. Sort of. You know, we're in the middle of like a COVID thing. And London, where I live, is actually on tier 4 right now, so stuff isn't that easy to get. We kind of just have to go with what we got. So we're looking for 100 grams of sugar. I'm doing this through my phone, it's very dangerous. Oh, 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 oh. No! 101 grams of sugar. Well, it says in the recipe, and we also need 3 tablespoons of golden syrup. It's, here we have a British classic. This is Lyle's golden syrup. You'll notice it's upside down. I couldn't open it. I just could not open it for the life of me. So I took a tin opener to it and cracked it open from the bottom. MacGyver my way to the top, folks. Right, so we need 3 tablespoons of this. It's going to be a little bit more because... Sorry, it's basically impossible to get an accurate tablespoon with something like golden syrup. And it's gone absolutely bloody everywhere. Oh yeah, that's the stuff. Oh, look at that, it's sexy. Told you, gingerbread is the sexiest. Don't tell your parents. Mom, BestInSlot says gingerbread's the sexiest biscuit. What do you think's the sexiest biscuit? And then I get cancelled by YouTube and life is over. All right, come on. Tablespoon. Sex. It's gorgeous. Really wish I wasn't doing this one-handed. I'm just creating these like spider webs of syrup between the two. It's beautiful though, isn't it? Look at that. Mmm. I should shoot for like adverts. Awkward baking. If I can bake with this stuff, anybody can bake with this stuff, in theory. People will be wondering, I don't really bake very often. I bake every now and again. I do like to cook quite a lot. These are massive tablespoons I'm doing here. I do like to cook quite a lot. I cook a lot more than I bake, but I bake every now and again. I made some shortbread recently, and I tend to do stuff at Halloween and stuff like that. That'll do. Let's wrap that bad boy around. Right. Come with me, YouTube. We stand. And we fight. I'm just going to put that in there. It's triggering me so much to not clean up as I go, but what are you going to do? We're going to take a little pan boy over here. Plop him down there. I'm gonna get some heat. Gonna get hard in here. And what we're gonna do is melt that down basically. And once all that is going on, I'm gonna tidy up. Okay, here we go. I haven't really left it to chill that long. It's gonna be warm. But it looks something like this. So you can see there's like a layer of like the butter fat, and then if you mix it, you see the sort of the brown underneath from the syrup kind of come to the fore. So, we're actually going to need this. I don't know how I'm going to do this. What we're going to do is we're going to come over here. We've got a big bowl. Big bowl. That's our flour, cinnamon, ginger, bicarb. We are going to take our little pan. Little pan. And we're going to mix the two. So we're just going to shove it in there. Bam. No faffing around. I'm just going to do some scraping. Bear with me, folks. For the scrapage. Scraping. How many of you thought you'd spend your evening looking at a black screen whilst the man sings scraping? Nobody, exactly. I'm providing new things. Bear with me! right, okay, so. The scrapings and other such things are together, so all we're going to do is give this a mix. And again, this is going to prove to be kind of a pain one-handed, but this does mix very well, as I learned when I did this earlier. Now, this is actually one of the reasons gingerbread's a pretty cool thing to make, especially if you've got kids or you just don't bake very often, you want to get started. I can't do this one-handed. gingerbread is, how the hell? Right, I'm going to put you in the bowl. Gingerbread's very resilient. So a lot of times when you're baking and you're mixing flour in something, you have to be very careful not to knock all the air out. With a gingerbread biscuit, you don't really need to worry about that. You can overwork it and it'll still turn out really well. Bloody Nora. It's very, very, very soft. We are going to chill it in a second. God, it looks bad there. We're going to chill it in a second. How the hell did I do that? There we go. It's not really rolling as opposed to squishing it down because it's so soft. What you should do, I think, is leave the wet stuff, the hot stuff. Give it a little bit more time to cool, basically, because I don't think 2 seconds, because I'm bored, is quite the length of time you should leave it. Get rid of that. None of that nonsense. It's just to stop it sticking. Anyway, so what we're going to do, I'm going to roll that out now because I can't do it here, clearly. I'm going to put that in the fridge for about an hour, and then we shall come back. Okay, folks, into the end game now. The oven is at 180 Celsius, and the dough has come out of the fridge. I left it in there for about 45 minutes. This thingy here suggests half an hour to an hour, and half an hour means it's easier to cut, but the indentation won't stick, and an hour means it'll be super easy to cut, but the indentation might be a bit hard. So I kind of went for the middle. So we have our dough. There is a line in it. There was no room in the fridge, so we're going to make do. Let's give this a go. I'm a little worried about these because these are plastic, and I feel like they should be metal, but we're going to give it a try. Triceratops. Press. Oh my god. Okay, I can see what they mean. I might need to double hand this, folks. Bear with me. I think I have to re-roll the dough a few times. It is going to get warmer, and that will probably help. I would suggest half an hour is a better idea. 40 minutes, especially if your fridge is pretty cold, which ours is, it seems like a little bit too long an amount of time. I'm going to cut out some shapes because I cannot do this one-handed, I'm afraid, and be back in a sec. There we go, folks. Two of each species. It's just like the Ark, but with dinosaurs, so therefore cooler. And we're going to do the indentations. I will say, for anyone who wants to do this, the dough rolled out and was a lot easier to control and play with, generally speaking, when it had been in the fridge for a little while. When it had been in the fridge and then warmed up again, so like half an hour in the fridge, I found rolling it to the right sort of thickness a lot easier and all that kind of jazz. So I think if I was doing this again, there they are, I would actually, that's what I would do. Now. We have to be very precise here, if at all possible, so let's get in nice and close. I'm going to try to match the stencil up with the trike, which is impossible because the trike has a weird head, basically. But I'll do what I can. Oh god, what's going on here? It might be because it's just getting warmer, so it's kind of like splatting a little bit. Let's see if we can mold the shape a little bit. There we go, that'll have to do. So, close enough. We're going to press down. Press. Don't know how hard to press, if I'm honest. So I'm going to press really bloody hard and assume that's the right idea. And then we're going to... Uh-oh, bear with me. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh no. Right, I've made a mistake here. Oh, for God's sake. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, beautiful. Come on, beautiful. Oh, she's looking cheeky. She's looking cheeky. Oh, that super requires 2 hands, though. Oh, that's so yum, yeah. Yum, yeah. Bear with me, folks. And there is our skeletal triceratops. So when this cooks through, all these holes will of course be cooked in, and then we'll flood it with icing and we should have a trike. Okay, let's... Finally then, there is our stegosaurus, which again, the lines are much more defined than our little trike here. Hopefully the second trike goes a little bit better, but that is 3 out of 6 done. So once that's finished, we'll skip forward at this point. Once that's finished, I will check, bear with me so you can follow along at home. We are gonna put these in the oven for 10 to 12 minutes. Probably 12, I would say. And then we're gonna take them out, they're gonna cool, then we're gonna ice them, and we'll be done. So I will see you in 10 to 12 minutes. Folks, I reckon they've had enough time. We are very close to saving the dinosaurs, bringing them back from the brink of extinction. Yes, they're still zombies, but that's okay. It's better than being dead. Gonna open this up. I was gonna leave them in longer, but I figure because these are they've got like the really thin bits, you know, where the indentation is, that we should bring them out. They're looking pretty good. Not the triceratops, but the others look okay. Let's go ahead and turn that off. Now what I've got over here is a wire rack thingamajiggy, because if you've got hot baked goods, which I always do, and you leave them in a tray, as they cool down, they will soften because there's no airflow underneath and the heat gets trapped. So, we need la spatula, and we're going to try to rescue them. Now, they're still a bit soft, but I'm hoping as they cool, they will harden. Okay, so obviously that didn't super duper work. That's okay. It's part of learning. There it is. I mean, it kind of worked. I kind of wiped the top of it a little bit, but it's not very bright, is it? The icing is too thin, basically. So I thicken the icing up quite a massive amount. We're not going to use a spoon. I have a chopstick, that famous baking utensil, and I'm going to try to basically use the end of the chopstick to dab icing into the gaps. That is the plan. You can see it's much whiter and thicker. Still not totally convinced, but let's give it a go. It's still too much. No. Oh my God, you really have to use like a teeny tiny amount. This is like precision stuff. It isn't my specialty, it must be said. Okay, let me just clean that up. Yeah, by eating it essentially. Yeah. At least no one else is going to eat these. It's better. This is going to take bloody ages. I figured this was for kids. There's no way kids have the patience to do this. It takes freaking years. Okay. Go. I'm trying to let you guys see what I'm doing. This is what paleontologists do. Exactly this. There's no difference. I'm basically Alan Grant, I'm just saying. This is how the dinosaurs came back in Jurassic Park. They just had to say it was the whole, amber thing, because that seemed more credible for their stockholders, you see. But really, they were baked by a man with a chopstick. Can't deny science. Actually, well, people keep trying, so never mind that one. Okay. It's looking a little bit messy. A little bit lenal, as they say. Okay, I'm gonna try to complete one of these completely. If I can do one really well, I'll be happy. But this is like impossible with one hand. With one hand. But there's a half done trike, so I'm gonna keep going with the trike. But what I'd really like to do is focus on this stegosaurus here. And the Rex isn't gonna work, but I'll try that as well. I'm just gonna mess around. I'm gonna see what I can do. I'll be back in a little bit. Pray for me, folks. Many, many moons later, I have finally finished this blimmin' thing. I have one of each to show you folks, and we're gonna go from worst to best. So, rather predictably, Monsieur Triceratops is in last place. It's just a little bit messy. I hadn't quite found my groove at this point in time. You know, I developed techniques as I did this over the last hour, maybe? It takes a long time. And the Triceratops is very chonky, you know, as you can see. A lot of the definition has been lost. But it's okay, the head is pretty good. It's not my best work, but it's okay. There you go, Triceratops. Third place. In second place, rather surprisingly, is the Stegosaurus. Now, I'm much happier with the Stegosaurus. You can see there's some nice line work there, particularly with the rib cage at the front. All the plates are there, all nicely filled in. It's even got an eye. You know, it's quite... There's more small details. You can see it's like little toes and stuff like that. He's looking pretty good, is Monsieur Stegosaurus. However, in a shock twist, taking first place, despite being an absolute monstrosity, is the Tyrannosaurus Rex. Now, not that detailed overall on the body. A lot of that got washed out. I had to pretend for a lot of this detail. I think if I was going to do this again, I actually would have wanted the dough even colder than it was. I think a lot of the problem was when I pressed it down, obviously the dough squished out a lot. Whereas if it was a lot colder, like say half an hour in the fridge, pull it out, do it straight away, it would have been a lot easier. I'm also wondering, and I've only just come to this conclusion, and I'll have to go look at the box to see what it says, but would it not be better to do the stencil on the dough and then cut out around the stencil? I'm about 100% sure that's what you're meant to do. That's definitely what you're meant to do, and I'm an idiot. But I was really proud of the Rex, mainly because, as you can see, the skull is fit. It really is. Like, there was barely any definition there, and I essentially drew a T-Rex skull using icing. I was in my moment here. I'd learned the drag and drop technique. I learned how much icing to use. And I think they came together really, really well. So let's put the gang together. Well, actually, it's kind of more like the herbivores trying to take down the Rex, but, yeah. There they are. Not bad. Not bad. You can see progression there. It was fun. It was kind of chill, relaxing. It reminded me a lot of, like, painting, like, you know, Warhammer 40k. That's kind of how it felt. Not sure it's something for the kids, but I think if you did it the other way around, which it might well be what the box says, honestly, I think it would go pretty well. And my problem was definitely the squishing. The squishing can ruin things. But I had fun. I hope you guys had fun as well. This was, and still is, Baking with BIS. Wow! The next 2 days are Christmas Eve and Christmas. I don't think I'll have my PC back. God knows what we'll do after that. We've done Planet Zoo Drawn. We've done baking. I've done a general update video. I might do a low-budget Draw Your Life. I might cook. I might make papier-mâché boats. Who knows what the future holds? If you have anything you'd like to see, let me know in the comments down below. I really hope you've enjoyed this video. I really hope you've been able to see this video, because it's like 10 different videos I have to somehow put together on my mobile phone. I have to try and find a video editor. It's been a long day, but I had a good time. Hope you guys did too. If you did enjoy this video, please hit the like button down below. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, myself, as always. Bye-bye.